Welcome back, everybody, to 7 Days to Die, Alpha 17 Experimental. I'm an old guy gaming, and we're going to continue our attempt at digging our hidey hole here. So don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and let's get started here. Okay, so, yeah, this is very precarious right at the moment, and I'm probably going to die horribly. Wouldn't be the first time, because these guys just won't leave me the hell alone. But what I think I'm going to do is I think I'm going to cut the camera while it's dark and, you know, just keep digging away here. And if anything, crazy happens, I'll start the camera again. Otherwise, I will see you guys, in when we get some daylight and we'll go from there. Okay. So I'll be back in a bit. Okay, guys, I just wanted to bring you back for a quick update. It's almost 1 o'clock in the morning. And what I've done is I've put a couple of frames there to block the entrance just to give me a little bit of time to react in case one of them comes in here. And I've also hit some stone here. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to start making the pitfall right around here so that, you know, this side of it is stone to capture, you know, any zombies that come through the entryway here. This is all very preliminary, of course. If this turns out to actually be, you know, somewhat effective, later on we might, you know, line it with some flagstone or cobblestone or whatever and make it a little bit better. But anyway, like I said, I just wanted to give you a quick update. And so I'm going to keep digging here, and I'll bring you guys back in just a little bit. Okay, bye. Okay, so zombie broke in, and she's currently on the spikes, and we killed her. Okay. Well, no, we haven't killed her yet. She broke through the frames that I had down there and then fell on some spikes that I quickly put down inside there. So, okay, I'm not even close, nowhere near close to being done with this, but it actually worked so far. So let's go ahead and expand this out. The one problem I have now, though, is her body's in the way. So I don't know how long it takes for those to despawn. Oh, it doesn't take long at all. Perfect. Okay. So that actually worked out pretty well. What we're gonna basically just do the same thing again. I'm gonna put some frames in there. Buy me enough time to turn around and throw another spike down there. If one breaks through. And let's also widen the pit a little bit here too, so we could actually get a couple of spikes down there. I might have to jump back down there to get to it. Okay, that's actually back to dirt. Well, this layer is anyway. Okay, and then can we reach here? No, we have to come back down. Okay, so let's just dig this out as quickly as possible. Digging through the stone here with this little stone axe is painful. It certainly is. One good thing, though, is that I can repair damaged stone with just cobble. And so I made cobble. So that way, if they start, you know, trying to damage this part here, I can repair it. So let's get this part dug out as quickly as possible. Okay, that's probably, nope, that's stone too. Okay, so we'll leave that the way it is. Okay, so that's good. So now we have a spot to put two spikes. I wonder if we should even maybe try three. Just in case, you know, we get more than one Z in here. I think we will. We'll make it a three spike pit. Now again, I realize that this isn't gonna do a whole lot of good for zombies that are trying to dig down from the top on us, but hopefully I'll get far enough along to where I'll be in under stone by that time, and that will be better than dirt, I'll put it that way, and we'll just figure out how to deal with it at that point. So we'll break this here. Okay, good. And like I said, maybe later on, depending upon how well this all, you know, ultimately turns out, I might dig this all out and actually line it with flagstone or, you know, whatever it is that we can use to do that with. Okay, so let's put that back there. And can we get up here? Nope. So we gotta set another. And then we can just kind of creep up in here for now. Let's pick those back up. And then what I'll do is we're just going to keep digging, but if another one tries to break through there, then we'll throw some spikes down. Okay, so we got to give ourselves a little more clearance up above this direction. Okay, we're into stone there, which is good actually. Because I want to get far enough into where we have stone over our head as well, like I said earlier. So we'll use the axe here. And let's see, it's 3:30 in the morning. So yeah, I'm gonna keep digging and boring down through here, and I'll bring you guys back after we make some more progress. Okay, so see you in a bit. Well, the game is once again doing everything it can to thwart me. I got into a gravel patch here, and I was hoping that it didn't go up and it would go down, but it goes way the hell up. And now, you know, all of that dirt that I was hoping would be between us and the zombies up top is no longer there. That really, really sucks. Super, super frustrating. Incredibly frustrating, because this was actually starting to work out pretty good. It even saved our life once, our little pitfall there. So now, I don't even know what to do about this now. It really sucks. Not going to lie, it really sucks. How close are we to the peak here? So I wanted to get, you know, right directly underneath that. I mean, it goes up quite a ways. So I'm trying to think of how to deal with this situation. One thing we definitely need to do is we need to get some sustenance going on here, because I'm running out of stamina pretty quickly. So let's put that on the wall and let's make a little side cubby hole. Oh, that's some kind of a metal. Okay, what about over here? It's probably iron, maybe? I don't know. It's hard to tell with the lighting. But yeah, my stamina is tanking because of all the digging that we're doing here. Looks like that might be metal too. Yeah, it is. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a little cubby here that we can then put a campfire in. We're going to cook up this food so we can get some stamina back. And we're going to drink our one can of water, and then we'll see where we're at after that. But yeah, that really sucks that that caved in, because now all it's going to take is a couple hits from some Z's up on top, and boom, they're in. Okay, well, let's just keep going. Let's keep going and do the best we can here. I'm trying to think of some way that I might be able to turn this to my advantage. Like having a big old trench here with spikes that they can all fall into. But then we have to figure out how we ourselves are going to get around it, you know? All right, let's cook all this up. We'll let that cook And then we'll drink our water after we're done eating all the meat there, and then we'll see where we're at. Yeah, see, that's all gravel. It's all very, very loose, very brittle. Very liable to come crashing down. In fact, some of it did and hurt me a little bit. You can see that I'm down to 81 health. Okay. See, I was hoping this would be just solid stone all the way through. It would have taken me a lot longer to dig this far, but the end result would have been far preferable, you know, from a defensive standpoint. I suppose what we could do is keep digging and see if we can get out of this gravel patch and back, you know, into normal stone. And if we can, then maybe what we do is we cut a side path to get around it. And then, you know, actually put spikes along this trench. So if and when they break through the top, they fall right down into the spikes. I don't know. We'll have to see. We'll have to see how we can, like I said, turn this to our advantage. I don't really want to start another hiding hole somewhere else just because... Oh, shit. I shouldn't have ate that so quickly. Just because I don't know... I mean, it was a fight just getting this one started, really, you know? And this seemed like an ideal spot. Okay, this should get us pretty damn high, both with health and stamina. Health gets all the way up to 98, stamina's up to 93. And that's it. Okay, let's go back over this way. See, this is stone right here. I wonder if we could maybe divert and go this way and see if we can go around this gravel. That's another possibility as well. So gravel starts right about here. That looks like, what is that? Oh, it's iron. Okay. Yeah, that's iron. Okay, so we got as much health as we can. Let's go ahead and drink this water. It doesn't get us real high. Oh, it looks like it goes up over time, so it doesn't give us instant satiation. That's probably not how you say that. But it is going up, though, so that's good. Okay. Well, yeah. Well, little glitch there. Not really sure what to do. Not really sure what to do here, you guys. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue digging straight this way. We'll leave that campfire there. And see if we can actually get through this vein and back into stone. Let's try that first. Okay, so that's actually stone right there. So maybe we have actually made it past the gravel. Good gravy. Or maybe not. Oh, we got company. There we go. Come on down onto the spikes, little girl. Look at that. Did I kill her? No, I think the spikes got her. The downside to using the spikes is you don't get the XP. But it's better than dying, though. Can I get another one to squeeze up in there? There we go. I probably... Can I get down far enough to repair that? Yeah. Good. Okay. Yeah, let's just leave that one down there for now, I guess. This gravel thing, man. Holy crap. This game is just fighting me tooth and nail. I tell you what. Fighting me tooth and nail. Okay, let's bust up this piece of stone here. I thought for a moment there maybe we had gotten through to the other side. But let's keep going. Break on through to the other side. We're actually in a kind of a precarious position here because, again, there's not much dirt up there between us and them. So all they'd have to do is dig down a little bit and bam, they're down inside. Okay. Okay, we're hitting probably iron here. Let's dig up above it a little bit. See, that's back into gravel. Okay, we got a new friend here. Let's see if we can... we got to conserve our spikes. We only have 6 left. Don't have a ton of wood either. Okay, come on down to the spikes there, buddy. Okay, good. I got the kill on that one. Okay, let's go down there and recover our arrows and put some more frames. So, I mean, this part of it's actually working reasonably well. Okay, let's just keep going here. We got it. Eventually, we have to be able to break through this. Is that nitrate? I don't know. I'm just waiting for it to collapse again. Not yet. Let's see. I gotta check out our time here too. I'm kind of lost track of time. All these starts and stops. I didn't get my clock going. So we are. Five. We're about 20-ish or so minutes into this now, I think. So let's set the timer for another 10. That's some very loose math there, so. But we'll go 10 more minutes. And then we'll end this episode. Okay, I gotta repair this guy. See if it collapses this time. Back away, back away. I don't want to be underneath it because that stuff hurts when it lands on your head. Still not going to collapse, are you? Okay. Well, One good thing about this spot is it could be our first mine when we get to the point where we can actually do something with a mine. It's not coming down. I don't trust it though. Take this down. It wants to stay there. Okay, if we go all the way back here, how far in are we now? See, we're almost right underneath the center of the mountain now. I'm not sure though where your person actually is on this arrow. Like if it's on the tip or in the middle. I wouldn't think it would be on the back. This just keeps going though. It's a huge, huge gravel deposit. Okay, now we're into some ore again. Well, I guess I don't really want to go this way because this hillside's pretty steep and we'll just bust out that way. But we could maybe turn and head this direction to the west, or to the east rather, and see if we can get back under some stone. As a possibility. And if we did that, I'd kind of want to stay underneath this stone here. So let's pick up that torch and set it there. And maybe pick this torch up too. And I think the plan will be that we'll start digging this way. But I'm going to, since it's daytime now, we got to go get some more water, and maybe what we'll do is we'll go grab all of our supplies off of the cabin roof and bring everything over here for now, because we know we can defend ourselves at least against one or two zombies with our nifty little pitfall set up here. And we need to make some more spikes to get more wood too. So let's do that. I'm going to just set this in here for now, except for it's not letting me put it down anywhere. We might need to make a little more room to set this down. Okay. I guess we'll cut into here. So, you know what, guys? I'll tell you what. Let's go ahead and just end this in the episode here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start punching the pathway through here, and hopefully we'll be able to stay in stone. I'm going to carve out just enough so I can get a bedroll down and probably a chest. And then when I'm done with that, then we'll come back in the next video, and we'll head on back out. We'll go get our stuff from the cabin. We'll go get some more water. We have two cans, and I think we might have a can left on the roof too. We'll get all that stuff and basically just move everything over here and move in. Okay, so thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Come and hang out with us on Discord, and come and hang out with me if you want to on a live stream. I do live stream on Twitch several times a week, and you can find the links to both of those places in the About section of the YouTube channel. You guys have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you next time around. Bye-bye.